Planet Dolan. From why we kiss to which species has the shortest lifespan, we answer 10 of your most burning questions about life.
Hey there, my name is Melissa. I'll be reading out the questions and answers.
I'm Danger Dolan, and I'm here to blow your mind with truth.
Metal Max 1991 asks, what would happen to a person if they were inside the Hadron Super Collider while it was active?
Their brains would fly out of their skull. It would be a huge mess. I tried this on Tolop, and there was brain wax jettisoned at the speed of light, collided, and created this new invention I made. I call it the candle. Hey mate, I'm sorry about that before. I tell you what, you buy this off me, and I will give you a discount. You fool.
If someone could be inside the collider while it was on, the particle would cut a hole right through that person. Also, the temperatures inside the collider would likely freeze them. However, the particle beam is only centimeters small, and there are security measures to stop anyone from being inside. Although, in the 1970s, this occurred in Russia in a similar machine. The particle passed through a man's head, leaving half his face paralyzed.
Speaking of which, Melissa, you look cold. You want to buy this incredible invention? It'll warm you up.
Oh, no, thanks. Hey, wait. Hey, is that Tolop's brain? Give that back to him right now!
It's called a candle, Melissa. Alright? He's just jealous.
Chris Lixon asks, why is my reflection upside down in a spoon?
Spoons are synonymous with psychics and the alternate world beyond ours. Using the power of psychokinetic energy, we've discovered an entire world beyond ours through the spoons. The world works and plays out exactly like our own, only everything is in reverse. People walk backwards, eat by regurgitating chewed food, and wash their hands, and then get them dirty. If a spoon is ever bending on its own, it's someone from the other world trying to break free.
Your reflection is upside down because the front of a spoon is a concave mirror, meaning it curves inward. Light travels in a straight line, and then when it hits the mirror, it is reflected by a different angle. The top part of the image is reflected downwards, and the bottom part upwards. Hence, the image is upside down.
Hey, Melissa, well, explain this. It's a little trick Emoji showed me.
Dolan, just because you bend a spoon doesn't mean... Emberly24 asks, is Murphy's Law a real law of science?
Look, guys, I like his movies just like the rest of you, but I don't entirely feel, based on your entire perception of science and reality on the words of Eddie Murphy alone, is wise. I don't know if you've seen the documentary called Trek, but the guy was a bit of a donkey, right?
At least you got the part about it being an Ed Murphy. I think you've been watching one too many movies, though. Murphy's Law is not a proven law of science, but it is based on a quote by U.S. Air Force engineer Edward A. Murphy after an experiment went wrong. The problem with proving Murphy's Law is that any attempt would itself probably go wrong. However, Murphy's Law is likely to occur frequently, since for every experiment, there is one ideal outcome and many ways it can go wrong. Night Lyrics asks, why do we kiss?
Kissing is the ultimate game of chicken. Two people bring their heads closer and closer together to see if the other person will pull out first. Kissing is a natural byproduct of two courageous people going all the way and pushing the game to its limits and standing their ground.
The best explanation as to why we kiss is that it is a way to select the right mate. By kissing, we exchange pheromones, which give us a sense of whether someone would be a good match. Kissing is a socially acceptable way, in most cultures, to get close enough to the other person for this exchange to occur. It also releases feel-good hormones, which can relieve stress.
You know, Melissa, being as bold as I am, I've kissed many times. Personally, I've never lost a game.
Oh yeah? Let's go.
Huh, you're on.
Victory! The honor belongs to me!
Ugh. No! Thanks. Thanks, Nixium. Aren't you great? You're great. Thanks.
ToxinShot23 asks, how did the periodic table come to be as we know it today?
Some dude was using an Excel spreadsheet, so he asked himself, what would Eddie Murphy do?
Ugh.
So, taking into account Murphy's Law, he scienced the spreadsheet so hard that it became a table of scientific periods. Periods of science. A periodic table, if you will. That's how it happened.
In 1969, Dmitri Mendeleev organized the elements by their atomic weight, putting them in vertical columns according to their properties and leaving space for elements that hadn't yet been discovered. This arrangement meant he could even predict the properties of future elements. In 1913, Henry Moseley then ordered them according to atomic number, compensating for some elements that were not in the correct order. Sonic XE asks, what would happen if no one voted in an election?
If no one voted in an election, we would have to go back to the medieval ways of settling things. A massive arena would be constructed. We'd have to fight to the death. I wasn't always running Planet Dolan on Earth. You think I just stumbled into this job? You know how many fools I cremated to become big boss Vegemite? You remember Shima? Didn't think so.
Oh, Dolan. I'm sorry, but that one was too far. I can handle the Eddie Murphy thing, but this is a step beyond.
You think I've forgotten about the kiss with Nixium? You're next, Melissa.
If people didn't vote in an election, it would be up to the Electoral College in each state to decide. Only a few states would be able to vote, since most electors can't vote differently from the voters. If the electors also didn't vote, or it was a tie, the House of Representatives would decide. If they didn't vote, then the Secretary of State would be president. Luke Heineking asks, why does a leap year add to February, and not any other month?
Because February is a terrible month. Nobody likes saying that word. Nobody likes writing that word. February? Do you know how many people just want it to be over already? Me. March is easy. Rolls off the tongue.
Leap years add to February because in the Roman calendar, March was the first month of the year. February also has less days than any other month because Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus removed 2 days so that August could have as many days as July, the month named after Julius Caesar. Since leap years began in ancient Rome, the tradition has been carried on.
Melissa, did you know that if you were born on the extra day for leap year, like myself, you age way slower, because you only have a birthday every 4 years?
Actually, that's not true at all. You still age every year just like everyone else.
What? No! Don't tell me that!
The Only Grim asks, which species has the shortest lifespan?
Humans. They only live for like 80 years. What a jerk! I bought things from the supermarket that expire later than that! Oh, hey Doopy, Andy, Froggy, Mimi, Legna. Sorry to break it to you guys. Hopefully you'll live long enough to see the end of the video, right guys? Awkward.
The adult mayfly has the shortest lifespan, around 24 hours, even less in some cases. However, this doesn't include the nymph stage of the mayfly, which lasts from a few months to over a year. The gastrotrich is an aquatic microorganism that lives from 3 to 4 days. They are only 3 millimeters in length and spend their life floating on water, eating and reproducing. Cog Big Dragon asks, why are there different units for most measurements in different countries, except for time?
Because nobody can agree. Euros, yen, dollars, pounds, kilo, inches, centimeters. You think anyone wants to deal with this rubbish? See, now if it were up to me, we'd be using the minted Australian didgeridoo dollar exclusively for everything. In fact, my whole numeric system. Oh hey, I've been exercising so much. Look at my body. I've lost 20 Dolan lucky kangaroo strips. Oh, that's amazing. That's almost 1,000 dangerous dingo bingo Dolans. Yeah, we can dream.
In fact, most nations use the international system of units, or metric system, except the US, Burma, and Liberia that still uses the old imperial system. The reason why everyone has adopted the same system of measurement for time is that it was necessary for international trade and transportation. These technologies developed in the Western world, where they used time measurement based on the stars that the ancient Greeks had used, so everyone had to follow suit. Geo the Fox asks, why are moths attracted to light?
Similar to how it's depicted in shows and movies, blinding bright light often signifies someone with beauty so immense it radiates off them like explosive sunlight. Moths are naturally very romantic, can't help themselves but to try and fly over and swoon whatever goddess is beyond the light.
Moths are positively phototactic, which means they naturally move towards light. It is thought that moths use light from the moon to navigate at night and are thrown off by other lights. It is impossible to navigate with the source so close, therefore, they just circle the light. When moths try to move back into the dark, their eyes cannot adjust quickly enough, so they end up staying back at the light again.
Oh, wow. She's beautiful. Amazing. What? Again? Nixium, stop pretending to be beautiful girls. I hate you so much.
Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a good one.